These sisters are active in the things of the Lord, and God has visited them with the testimony of a new job. May that be our portion as we serve in Jesus' name. We want to hear another testimony of a mighty open door from one of us. He's standing before you. Please tell us your name and what you do and what prophecy you got from this mount and how it came to pass.
Mount Olive. Mount Olive. Mount Olive. God is one. Of a truth, God is always at work here. Hallelujah. My name is Pastor Davidson. I am here to return all the glory to God of this mountain and also to celebrate our father, that generational prophet. It happened that last year, it was towards the ending of August, that was my first encounter with the prophet of God. And I came here, that was on a Wednesday prayer. And then towards the ending of the program, he called me out. And then he confirmed my calling. And he told me about my calling. And then the ministry that God has given to me.
You are calling as what?
As a pastor. He said, you are a pastor? I said, yes. He spoke to me, but time was against. He said, I should come back. He will finish my prophecy. So I left that day to come back the Sunday. So on that very Sunday, I came because I was pastoring a branch then. And then I came late. I was outside because here we're full up. So while I was there, I was trying to get entrance from this place. But the security people, they didn't allow me enter. But that day, the man of God was prophesying heavily. And then he was prophesying and he said, and I quote, he said, today he will prophesy. That if he is going on the road, he will prophesy. If you see him, if he's entering his house, he will prophesy. That even when he died, that he will prophesy in the land of the dead. So while he was making that declaration, I was out there, I said, God, I want this man to prophesy to me today. Immediately I said that in my heart. I don't know, but the Spirit of God brought the man of God to that entrance. And then he called me. He said, come, young man. He said, this covenant between you and your family that does not want you to prosper, that does not want you to excel in ministry, I break it. He said, go, you will prosper. That same day. Hear me. The grace in this altar, the grace in this altar is cash and carry. That same day, I left for the fellowship in my house because then the ministry that God has given to me, we were doing the fellowship in the house, in my parlor. So while we were doing the fellowship, after the fellowship, a brother, I normally pray for him, he came to me. He said while he was offshore, that God told him to give me a land. There's a land here somewhere. And God instructed him to give it to me. Now listen to me. That was not the week he came back. He had been there, he had come back for 3 weeks before that time. And then we have been seeing, I've prayed for him. He has been coming around. But that day, after the encounter with the great prophet, Prophet David Udo Udo, he told me about the document. I thought it was a joke. The next Sunday, he came with a wife and they handed the document over to me. That is not all. It was on May, another encounter. This year, May, I think on the 21st, I came to this place. Though I was not looking for prophecy, but while I was seated there, the man of God came to me and called me. He said, where is the name of the ministry? As if I told him. Right up to that time, I had the handbill of the ministry with me, and then I came with the seal to connect. So he said to me, where is the name of the ministry, Pastor? And I was out there. He said, come. There is a problem. He said, there is an arrow as you started. Have you seen what is happening? I said, yes. He said, they fired you arrow of stroke. He said, and then I handed him over the seed that I came with. He said, today, that arrow will leave me. And then he declared a word of prayer for me. And of a truth, the Lord has been taking charge. That attack, the Lord is on it. And I'm here to return all the glory to God. The third thing that God did in the space of 1 year as I made the prophet of God, is that the same land that the Lord gave to me through the Sabbath. And I was the day we had a program here. So I came with the design, the architectural design of the building I want to build. And then Daddy was laying hands on people. And then Daddy, I brought the paper, he put it on my head and laid hand on me. And then what happened is that this last week, Wednesday, to the glory of God, I was able to do the foundation of that building. And as I'm talking to you now, the Lord is doing mighty things. Above all, the ministry that was in the room, the Lord has given us a place of worship. And that came by my encounter with the servant of God. Another thing that God did this month is that this month is my month of birth. Not only my month of birth, my daughter's month of birth. Not only that, my mother's month of birth. And she's 79 and she's still standing. And my elder brother's month of birth. So it's a wonderful month. I am here to return all the glory to the Lord Almighty and to celebrate my father, Prophet David Udo Udo. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you for being a father. Thank you.
Church, you cannot sit down and celebrate this God. Rise up and make a joyful noise. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Father, Lord, we cannot thank you enough because our pastor here has said it all. Pastor, congratulations. The best has not come.
Amen.
As you continue to key into the grace of God Almighty in this mount through his servant, the word of 2 Chronicles 20:20 says you will continue to succeed.
Amen.
But I want you to please share a little bit of what you went through as a challenge in the ministry that led you to the prophet. You said there was no favor. This particular blessing you got, the person has been there.
Yes.
And yet he never blessed you.
Prior to this time, I'll pray for people. When God bless them, they will run. It's only few of them that is always coming close. And I know when I pray for them and the Lord will open their door, sometimes they will come with one excuse and they will go. And then the man of God looked at me and said, this idol from your father's house that is blocking your way, that he destroyed that idol. And of a truth, since then, there is a change. And that I'm here to return the glory to God.
We praise God because we serve a God who opens doors.
Amen.
We serve a God who the Bible refers to in Revelation 3:8, that when he opens a door, can any man shut the doors? That is what we are experiencing. And I'm sure as many as are keen into today's testimonies, our doors will remain open in Jesus' name.
Amen.